Hi, I'm Ian McShane, and this is The First Time. Actually, it was funny because I worked with Michael Green, who created, was a showrunner the first year.
So who are you?
You wouldn't believe in me if I told you.
I'd done Kings with him back in 2008.
Then it's not who I am.
Oh, if only it was.
And then they came in, and it was strange. It's just 2016. And Michael's, they offered me this script. They said, there's a fascinating part. You know, we'd love you to come in, Ian, and maybe, you know, there's this character, Chernobog. So I read the book and I said, well, no, I said, I don't think I'm, and the script they sent me. I said, I don't think I'm really right for this. I said, it's very nice. I said, but, you know, there's another character, but I'm sure you got it out, Mr. Wednesday. I said, a little more interesting, but whatever. And Michael said, well, you know, we'll talk about that. What he said, I thought you might not want to do a series. He said, because this would be more of a guest. I said, well, whatever. But Mr. Wednesday was, I sort of, that's what I had my eye on. And sure enough, 2 days later, they came back and offered it me.
And that's when Wednesday showed up.
First time he came on the set of American Gods, the first day that Ricky and I did the very first scene on the third day of filming in Toronto. They had a technical glitch, so they wouldn't shoot anything for 2 hours. So I got to, you know, we had a nice chat around. It was good. The start of a beautiful friendship. I think my dad was playing there back in the 50s. I mean, that's like, I still watch it. Manchester United is very much part of my life. I mean, because I grew up with it. My dad, it was the last team he played for. He went there in 1950. He retired in 55, but we retired in Manchester. I went to school opposite the ground. It's a way of life, you know? Those, put on that, see that red shirt trotting on the field? I'm sitting here in the beach and here in Venice, California. You know, I get my scarf out, put it on, make a nice cup of tea, you know? Get the rattle out. Oh, Manchester United. No, I don't, but that's where I am spiritually. They talked about it for years. And the thing, of course, was the script and getting the time of the people together. I mean, David always had the idea. And I was thrilled. I think we all were. We did the show, though, I got to tell you, when we filmed it, it was like an out-of-the-body experience. And it was just like stepping back into it, even after 14 years later.
Hearst won't take long, for he honors the rigors of his putrid fucking nature.
And of course, we've been in touch with each other over the years, and it was one of the strangest, happiest, saddest experiences you'll ever have, you know? It really was, because you know this was the end, you know? This was the end. I mean, it was a great idea. And when I first read it, I put it on, I thought, it's a great part. It's a great guest part. It'd be fun to do. And, you know, Keanu.
Hello, Winston. Jonathan.
A dead wife, a dog, a great car, and he's an assassin. Can't go wrong. And, you know, number two came and number three, and now we're probably going to do, this year we'll probably do number four, yeah, later in the year. But that was how that came about. And it was a really good movie. I remember I was filming down in Atlanta and I snuck into the early showing down there, like 12 o'clock. And as soon as you see the first 10 minutes, you know, it's the same with any movie. You go, oh yeah, this is going to work. The first time I did a book narration was the last time I did a book narration. No, it's not exactly true. I did a couple of narrations, which I actually loved. I loved them. It depends the book. You know, sometimes they'll ask you. I mean, I'm going back now, but I did a couple in England, Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn, Henry Miller. I mean, they're two erotica books, you know, but they were fun to do. That was fun. But then I did a book of my own show, Lovejoy. And I thought, gee, I read it and I thought, no wonder we changed the book into something else, because it wasn't exactly the best book ever written. Anyway, with all respect to Jonathan Gash, who wrote the books. The guy who I worked with for years, who was my partner on a show I did called Lovejoy in England, was a guy called Alan McEwen, who was also married to Tracy Ullman. And that's where The Simpsons appeared on Tracy's show. And it was like hilarious. I mean, I said, when I remember seeing, thinking, this is great. But, I mean, it's always been consistently the best show on TV, you know, the best written, the funniest. They're all brilliant, the voiceovers. And yeah, and I did one. This just did one. They wrote one and said, it's about time you did one. So it'll be out in the spring when I'm playing the patron saint of bartenders, I believe. Best thing is, in all the pandemic, not because I said I don't want to work, and then the phone call came in. Would you like to do? They've written The Simpsons. They like you to do. I said, terrific. That's the only thing I want to do. I was going around to an American friend's in London for dinner. He said, I've got a friend of mine from California is here for dinner. So I just like, well, be an extra person. This is Marlon Brando. And I sort of, I don't think I could speak for about 10 minutes. I just was, nice to meet you. You never want your idols to have feet of clay. And he was absolutely tremendous. We had he was very funny, very charming. And I was like, just wanted to look at him. And at the end of it, he said, well, I'm going down with Ronnie Scott's to hear some jazz. You all going to go? And I thought, no, I can't. I want this memory. I can't. It'd be too much to get, because I'll think then I'm his friend. And I'm not his friend. I want this moment for me. I said, it's been great. I've got to go home. And fabulous. And that's like a great memory of somebody. Because, you know, the memory is forever like pure. It's not solid by anything. And then I went, last time I saw him, it was on, you know, Last Tango in Paris, The Godfather, and you go, oh, Jesus.